Hi everyone, this is Julia from Dodge Nature Center, and today I have a demonstration for you on erosion. Now, erosion is the removal of soil from its original place and can be caused by things like rain, wind, or way long time ago when the glaciers moved through Minnesota, the ice actually could form and shape the land. Today, what we're going to be looking at is how erosion, specifically from rainfall, can impact the different areas here at Dodge Nature Center. So for my demonstration today, I've collected a couple samples. The first sample over here is from Challenge Hill. And Challenge Hill is an exposed hill, mostly just dirt and rocks, with several trees kind of intermittently placed. The second sample is from Maple Hill, and this is more of a wooded area, and as you can see, there's dead plant matter, leaves, twigs, kind of on top of the soil. And the third place I went to was the prairie, and I collected a sample from the hillside. And as you can see in this sample, there's actually grasses and plants growing in the soil. So in this demonstration, we're going to be focusing on how rainfall can cause erosion in different areas. So we're going to start with the Challenge Hill ground, and I want you to make a prediction about how much erosion you think is going to be happening. And the sign that erosion is occurring is, again, that soil moving from its original place. So whatever gets collected down here in this cup from the runoff, depending on how much soil is in there, we'll know how much erosion happened. So go ahead and make a prediction. What do you think will happen? And now I'm going to pour the water. All right, and let's watch to see. All right, so you can see in our cup, the water is really mucky and full of sediment. So quite a bit of erosion was happening. As the rainfall fell into the soil, it kind of carried away a lot of it with it into the water. Let's move to the next location, the Maple Hill soil. And remember, it has leaves and sticks on the top. So make a prediction about how you think erosion will occur in this scenario. And then I'm gonna pour the water. All right, and let's compare these two cups. As you can see, the Maple Hill soil that had that dead leaf matter and sticks and twigs had a lot less sediment coming out of it, and the water stayed much clearer. Let's move on to the third one, our prairie. Make a prediction. What do you think will happen with the actual plants growing in the soil? I'm trying to pour the same amount in all three cups. But what are you noticing about this third one? The water's not dropping or dripping out nearly as quickly. And why do you think that might be? So let's think about these three examples. A lot less soil and a lot less erosion, even a lot less water, is even moving through this ground sample as compared to these two ground samples. And that's because there's something different about this ground. There's something actually in the ground. Think you know what it is? Think about the plants and think about what's underground with those plants. If I lift up this soil, I can show you that under the plants is a whole root system. And the root system is really what's helping prevent the erosion from happening. The roots can almost work like a net or a hand, like fingers, to capture the water and hold it, and they absorb the water. And so rather than letting the soil drain out and be eroded, it actually holds it in place. And so that's why in places where there's a lot of vegetation, like our prairie hillside, you're not gonna see very much erosion as compared to places like Challenge Hill, where it's an open hillside and there's not that vegetation to kind of hold the soil in place. Well, thanks for watching. And we'll see you next time.